All right, you saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's solo challenge. Madden Ultimate Team, go earn your keep. And the offense readies for a first down and 10. Now a first down throw, Locke. Now a hit, and Locke lost the football. It's out, and it's scooped up by the Jets. And it's a touchdown for the Jets. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave them a comfortable lead.
Carlson on for the PAT. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And he is going to be taken down inside the 5 at the 4-yard line. All right, nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from where I sit. Congratulations. Good job on this Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. Following the fourth lead change in the game, the Colts are ahead. You only have about 2 minutes left to drive down the field, take back the lead, and win the game. Here come the Jets now as they get set to go on first down. He's back to throw. Over the middle here to Brown. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Jet first down, 18 big yards that time.
That gets them the first down, but they've still got to move quickly here.
Back to throw. Flushed out right. And he's got some space here. Powering his way forward. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. Late in the game, defense tried to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know in this situation, everything is sped up. the intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatlining, leveling everything he does, and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. The two big plays, one after the other. Now all of a sudden, they're on the march.
Got to feel good about what they've just gotten done, and now feel really good about what's in front of them.
And Brown's got it. He's got a Jets touchdown. Antonio Brown, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Jets have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Carlson now to kick this one away. This is taken near the 13. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. They'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, incomplete. Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or Drake ball over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send them out to the quarterback and then make sure you blanket the field.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third. So this defense, they looked a little shaky to start the drive. The bottom line, they're a play away from finishing it off.
They rocked them a little bit on this drive, didn't they? But as you and I both know, it's not how you start. It's how you finish. They have a chance to end it right here.
And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. So they had to take the shot there. Obviously, that was pretty much it, their last chance.
No other play for them, right? I mean, there's no other choice. It's not like you can have some strategy move, right? Punt it away and hope that's what they had to do. Right now, that offensive unit, they're pretty discouraged on the sidelines. They're going to feel like they let the team down in that situation, but they were in a tough spot to begin with.
And with no timeouts now, they just need a miracle.
Yeah, an absolute miracle. If the team has the ball, just find a way to run out the clock, take care of the ball, and go home with a winner.
And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, is intended target. And now it's second down.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
That fourth quarter, maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there, the legs still there? This has been a tough game. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. Well, they've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal? And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
Extra point by Carlson. Up and good. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Carlson now to kick this one away. This will be taken short. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. One last throw here for Locke. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. That was perfect execution, a classic two-minute drill. Congratulations, and see you next week when you take on the Bills in Buffalo. Bring a coat, because have a feeling it's going to be a cold one. The Bills opened this frosty game with a scoring drive that culminated with a 10-yard rushing touchdown by LeSean McCoy. Now let's see if you can do even better. And the offense gets set here for a third down play. On third down, Miller. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Lamar Miller, a 12-yard touchdown run. Great job outperforming the Bills with an even longer touchdown rush. The Bills responded with another scoring drive where they rushed 8 times for a total of 63 yards. Show them that not only will you match their performance, but you'll surpass it. And now the offense getting set, first and 10. A first down carry now for Miller. And some room to run now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A jet first down, 18 big yards that time. They keep it with Miller on first down. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. On 2nd down, here's Miller. And he had a quick little spin move, but the door shut fast as he's dropped. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or 2 short here with 3rd down coming up. They'll try to run for it with Miller. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage to the 35. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Tenth carry now for Lamar Miller. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give them 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. Here's a give to Miller. And he's got 4 down inside the 20 to the 18. Now a handoff to Miller. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up 1st and goal.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
They'll try and run for it with Miller. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Didn't work out this time, but there's always next time. And we'll see you next time right here on the Solo Challenge for Madden Ultimate Team. And the offense readies for a 1st down and 10. Miller. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That's good for a Jet 1st down, a gain of 13. Running game working, they'll stick with it on 1st down. And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. So 1st and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 38. This is Miller. And now running right through it. Fighting through it. He's got space. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Incredible performance. Keep showing the Bills that even in the snow, you will not be outdone. The Bills followed up with another touchdown before the half ended. Unfortunately, the back and forth ended there when your team failed to score on their first drive of the second half. Now you're on defense, and you'll need to stop the Bills from scoring to keep their lead at a minimum. The Bills offense ready to go here on first and 10. Throwing on first. Here's McCarron. Curley's got it. Complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Green, 39. Green.
On second down, here's McCarron. Benjamin with it over the middle. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Set, 3-19.
Now here's McCarron on third. Oh, battling at the line and intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he'll take this back down inside the 20. Great job shutting down the Bills' running game and preventing them from scoring any more points. Your drive stalled out, but not before making it into field goal range. Boot a 35-yard field goal to cut down the Bills' lead. Now to try the field goal, here's Daniel Carlson. This one from 35 yards away. The kick by Carlson is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. Great job there, eating into the Bills' advantage. Here come the Jets now as they get set to go on first down. Vic will look to throw on first down. Flush to his right. Now he'll let it go. Got a man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Great performance. An incredible touchdown pass. Now your team is back in the game with a small chance for a comeback. The Bills snuffed out any hope of you winning this game when they returned your kick for a touchdown. But go down swinging by scoring one last touchdown of your own with just 38 seconds remaining. And now the offense getting set, first and 10. On first and 10, here's Vic. Now a desperation throw. And this will be caught at the 30. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Good job by giving it your all in this snowy showdown against the Bills. Now, you did lose the game, but at least it was a close one. And the good news, next week's game is at home.